Back again. Now we're doing similarity shapes, but now we're looking at algebra. So we're including algebraic expressions and solving for x. When we know the shapes are similar, we can do certain things. So let's check it out. Over here on number 19 in the packet, we have a shape like this and a shape like that, and it says that the shapes are similar. So that's going to make a big difference. It means that this to this is as this to this. In other words, as a ratio, 21 is to 51 as 2x plus 3 is to 34. And we can write this as a fraction. The ratio between this and this is in proportion to this and this. The key to this is that the 21 and 51 are on top and the 2x plus 3 and 34 on the bottom. That preserves the ratio, the scale factor in the ratio. Now we solve this as cross multiplying. We go ahead, 21 times 34 and 51 times 2x plus 3. So 21 times 34 is here, 51 times 2x plus 3, 34 times 21 is 714. Obviously we did the calculations offline so that we could go quicker. 51 times 2 is going to be 102x, 51 times 3 is 153. We then subtract the 153 here and here, right? And we get 102x equals 561. This is 561. We just commuted the, you can do that, you can change the sides of the equation. Now we divide by 102 on both sides and we get 5.5 for x. And that's all we have to do. This problem was simply just to solve for x. You always gotta give, you know, heads up for what the question is asking you. It's asking you for x. That's all it's saying. It's not asking you for the scale factor. It's just saying what value of x would you need in order for this to work. So let's go to the next question, number 21. We've got a triangle here, A, B, C, similar to D, E, F. Okay, so that preserves the shape. In this case, they don't always, but it does here. So we've got the measurements for this one, smaller one, and then the measurements for this one, we need to find x and y. How can we do that? What do we do? What clue do we have? Well, the only clue we really have is that they are similar. And again, when it tells you they're similar, that's a huge clue because we know that this 16 and that 32 can be compared, and pretty easily we can see that this one, the big one, is twice as big as the small one. So if we now know how much more this is big, how bigger this is, how much bigger this is, then we, that preserves the ratio for these sides as well. So that's simple. And if this is twice as big as that, 32 over 16, again, we're gonna write that ratio over here. So 16 over 32. We can go 16 over 32, small to large. Then we know that 9 has got to be to 18. And then we know that also 15 is going to be 30. That's preserving the scale factor and the ratio. So those are your answers. X is going to be equal to 18, and Y is equal to 30. And that's all you got to do. And so it's that simple. Once you know shapes are similar, the key is, in this case, in the bottom case, to find what the scale factor is. How much did it expand? It's two times as big as the other triangle, so therefore we can therefore say that all the sides are twice as big as well. The previous example was algebraic. We had to solve for x. Once you know they're similar again, you know that the sides are going to be proportionate, and you can set up a ratio cross multiply. Solve for x. Presto, you are